Every Name Counts is a crowdsourcing initiative with the aim of digitizing all the documents we have in the archives and building the digital memorial for the victims of the Nazis. The archives were set up by the Allied forces, not as an archive, but as a tracing service. The Western Allied forces were aware that due to the war, lots of people had been displaced. Lots of people were lost and families were torn apart. It was very important to collect the information about their whereabouts. That's what they did, so that after the end of the war, people would be searching for the loved ones would be helped to find their family members. The Accenture involvement started with one person, and it's very often what how it works. One person started getting involved in the Every Name Counts project and cared deeply about the digital memorial and how important it was to keep the records and to make them accessible to everybody. The document is not always easy to read. Sometimes it's handwritten. So there is generally a difficulty to read the document. And then we are talking here about names. Very often what is on the documents, mainly on the documents, are names, names of people and names of places. And these are generally the document that this is what is difficult to recognize because every name is different. So this is what makes it's so difficult to actually transcribe these documents and why for so many years and so many decades we've been doing this manually. Accenture people, being Accenture people, they wanted to know more about the process. What would happen with the data that they would index and how was it in the end integrated in a database? And they saw very quickly and with us together that the process was very cumbersome and very slow. And with the technology that is at the disposal of Accenture, there was this offer from the side of Accenture to actually help us to index many of the documents thanks to AI technology. And I have to say, the results that I've seen so far are absolutely stunning. This will help us it will help us digitize much, much more quickly and for the archives. We're not talking about decades anymore, but maybe about a few years. And also, not only in this expand the scope of digitization, but also the depth of digitization. What we want to do with the archives and with all the data that we hope to harvest from these crowdsourcing initiatives, from the AI initiatives, is that we will be able to tell stories, human stories, to future, to young generations, to future generations, in a way that touches their hearts. Why? Because without emotion, it is very difficult, actually, to transmit lessons about history. And this is why, as well, around these individual stories, about the victims, about the survivors, we want to tell more about the context in which it took place, so that younger generations, future generations, can recognize the patterns and trends and act upon it.